Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Madam Secretary, let's go to the subject of worksite enforcement. Today in the United States, there are 15 million people who are out of work. They and their families are hurting greatly. Yet at the same time, we have about 7 million people in the country who are working here illegally. If we were to just enforce the current immigration laws on the books, we might cut unemployment in half. When I think about the impact that could have on our country if we did enforce the laws and cut that unemployment rate in half, you have the opportunity to be a national heroine by enforcing the laws. And let me give you some facts about what I perceive as a lack of enforcement. In the area of administration, administrative arrests are down 68%. Criminal arrest, down 60%. Criminal indictments, down 58%, and criminal convictions down 63%. In all those categories, arrest, indictments, convictions, they're all down 58 to 68%, all in 1 year. That's quite a record. My question is, why don't we enforce immigration laws and create more jobs for unemployed Americans?
Well, Representative Smith, let me just say that I believe that enforcement of our nation's immigration laws is not only important, but particularly when we have an unemployment rate in a country the way we do, to make sure that we have effective worksite enforcement. So let me describe how we've gone about it.
Well, if you'd answer my question first about why these statistics are down so much, arrest, the indictments, the convictions are all down.
Indeed. Let me answer that directly. First of all, I-9 audits of companies are up substantially, record numbers. Yep. We can bring more.
Let me concede that. Audits are up, notices of intent to fine. By the way, notice of intent. Even when they're fined, the company is considered just the cost of doing business. If you want to reduce the number of illegal workers, these statistics should have gone the opposite direction. Why don't you let your ICE agents arrest more people, detain more people, and free up those jobs for unemployed Americans?
Can I speak?
Please. I hope you'll answer the question.
All right. Let me describe what we're doing. We have substantially increased I-9 audits. More employers are being subject to fine. We have more employers than ever signed up on E-Verify to verify legal residency before you even begin employment. We have record numbers of criminal alien removals from this country, record numbers of criminal alien arrests in this country, more than any other year prior to this.
But we're talking about worksite enforcement. Worksite enforcement.
And worksite enforcement is all part of that. So I think if you spoke with members of the business community, they would say, get ICE off our backs, because they're all over the place making sure that we comply with the immigration laws. We will continue to do that.
I'm not hearing that. I don't think many of those criminal aliens were worksite enforcement cases. I'm talking about individuals who are working illegally in the country, and if we were to enforce our immigration laws, we could free up those positions for a lot of unemployed Americans. Let me go to U.S. Visit. As you know, we have a budget this year proposed by the administration that did not request a single dollar for the U.S. Visit exit side of the program. U.S. Visit was implemented. It was a bill that I introduced in 1996 that became law. And as you know better than I, 40% of all the people in the country illegally are visa overstayers. If you want to know who they are, if you want to know whether they've left this country or not, you have to have an exit system. The administration does not have any money for that exit, for that biometric exit system. Why aren't they interested in reducing the 40% number of the people who are in the country illegally? You can't do it unless you know who they are.
Well, I don't think, Representative, your question presumes that there is no money for U.S. Visit. The fact of the matter is that there's...
No, I just asked you why there wasn't an increase if you're going to increase the money for U.S. Exit.
Please, there's $50 million that has been unallocated that we are carrying forward for U.S. Visit.
Okay. Let's hope you implement the program if you're serious about addressing that problem. My last question is a follow-up to the ranking member's question a while ago when he asked you what other cities were being considered as locations to try the Gitmo detainees. You responded by saying the DOJ was assessing it, but his question was, what other cities are being considered, not who was assessing it? And let's stipulate that no decision has been made as to which city, but surely you know what cities are being considered, and on behalf of the American people, I'd like to ask you, what are those cities?
Representative, I am not privy to that information right now.
Do you know what you do not know what cities are being considered, and your Secretary of the Department of Homeland Security?
Sir, I personally am not part of those discussions.
That's okay. Correct. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.